Good morning, students. Today we are taking the revision of the whole chapter 1, that is a relation and function. Now we know that how much we have studied in this chapter, that is first is the type of the relation. In the type of the relation we have seen there are three type of the relation. First is the reflexive, symmetric and transitive. So let us see few questions based on it. What is the reflexive? That A belongs to R for every A belongs to R. A belongs to R for all A belongs to capital A. If R is defined on such a set A. Second is the symmetric. If AB belongs to R, then BA belongs to R. For every AB belongs to R, then A and B are belongs to A. So this is symmetric. Then transitive. If AB and BC belongs to R, then AC belongs to R. So these are three things we are having in this. Now let me see some questions based on this. Okay, so today we will see few MCQs or one mark question based on this. So first is from exercise 1.1, question number. Question number 15. So that I am saying here, question number 15 from the exercise 1.1. So let R be the relation in the set 1, 2, 3, 4. So here set A is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4. And the relation R is given as 1, 2, 2, 2, 1, 1, 4, 4. 1, 3, 3, 3, and 3, 2. Then choose the correct answer, that R is reflexive and symmetric but not transitive. R is reflexive and transitive. So here, let me check what can be happen here. First, R is reflexive as 1, 1, 1, 2, 3. So we can say it is a reflexive. So it is yes. No need to give the reason. Directly you can check 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 and 4, 4. Is there? So it is reflexive. Now symmetry. For symmetry we require for every AB belongs to R, BA belongs to that. So here I can check for 1, 2. If 1, 2 is there, then 4, 3 must be there. But it is not. So I should write down no here reason. That is only for R explanation, as 1, 2 belongs to R, but 2, 1 does not belong to R, therefore no symmetry. What can be happen with transitive? Okay, so now for transitive, we have to check the elements. So here 1, 2, then 2, 2. Okay, 1, 2 and 2, 2, then 1, 2 should be left. So yes. Again 1, 3 and 3, 3. So 1, 3 is there. 1, 3 and 3, 2. Then 1, 2 should be there. Yes. So whatever available elements are here. Okay, element here. All the available element for this. The transitive property is satisfied. So therefore transitivity is yes. And therefore our answer is R is reflexive and transitive but not symmetric. So you can check. Which one is this? Reflexive and transitive but not symmetric, and that is your answer, option number B. Now let me see the next question, that is a question number 16 from same exercise 1.1. So question is, R be the relation in the set N given by AB where B is equals to R square. A is equals to B minus 2 and B is greater than 6. Then choose the correct answer. 2, 4 belongs to R. 3, 8 belongs to R. Option C. 6, 8 belongs to R. And 8, 7 belongs to R. Now students, very easy equation. As you have A is equals to B minus 2. That means the difference is 2. Okay, if you write down there. And B minus A is equals to 2. So you can check in which of the following B minus A is equals to 2. So you can check easily. So your answer is, I am writing here C. That is 6, 8 belongs to R because 8 is equals to 8 minus 6 is equals to 2. So easy equation. Now this is based on the types of the relation. There are few more questions based on this. That is from the miscellaneous. So let me see few questions from there also. Now in the miscellaneous you can see question number 16. So here from the miscellaneous I am taking a question. Question number 16. So question number 16 is, if A is equals to 1, 2, 3, then how many, then the number of relations containing 1, 2 and 1, 3 which are reflexive, symmetric but not transitive. So here the question we have to see, that we have to find out the relation R, okay, which is reflexive. So for the reflexive it is clear we have to add these three elements. Okay, relation is reflexive if and only all the three elements 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 must be there. Now this relation is containing 1, 2 and 1, 3. So I am adding here 1, 2 and 1, 3. Now question is, the relation is which are reflexive and symmetric but not transitive. So if we are adding 1, 2, so if we have to make symmetric banana hai, we have to add 2, 1. Similarly 3, 1 hai aur usko hame symmetric banana hai, so it is 3, 1. Okay, so now this is the relation which is reflexive and symmetric. So yes, reflexive and symmetric. Now let us check the transitivity for this. So is it transitive? So if I write down 3, 1, we are having 3, 1 and 1, 2. I am taking this element for example. So here 3, 1 and 1, 2 which belongs to R. But for the transitivity we require AC, that is 3, 2 which is belongs to R. Is it belongs to here? 3, 2 is there? No, but it is not. Therefore it is not transitive. So here the first relation we found, which is reflexive and symmetric but not transitive. Now for the transitivity we have to find out another relation. So let me find out the relation R, which is the combination of all the elements given here. So aapko hi pata hai agar relation ka find karna hai to let me write down all the elements which are related to each other. मतलब कि 1 से सब एलिमेंट रिलेटेड हो, 2 से रिलेटेड हो, 3. सो फॉर दिस आई एम राइटिंग लाइक दिस 1, 1, 1 is 2 and 1. तो 1 से सारे रिलेटेड एलिमेंट आ गए हमारे. नाउ व्हेन वी सी 4, 2 देन 2, 1, 2, 2 and 2. 4, 3 3, 1, 3, 2 and 3. सो हियर द रिलेशन वी आर हैविंग, दैट दिस इज द रिलेशन व्हिच इज एन इक्विवेलेंस रिलेशन एंड we can say the containing the biggest relation on this set A. Okay, so now with this let me compare which elements are there. So 1, 1 is here, 2, 2 is here, 3, 3 is here, 1, 2 and 2, 1 is there, 1, 3 and 3, 1 is there. So now remaining is 2, 3 and 3, 2. So let me see what happened if I add here 2, 3 and 3. So for this relation I am writing here R1. Let me write down R1. R2 is equals to 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 1, 2, 2, 1, 1, 3, 3, 1. Now I am adding one element, 2, 3. So if I will add 2, 3, then is it reflexive? So let me check here. Again the same one, that is 3, 1. And 3, 1 and 1, 2 is there, yes. Then 3, 2 is there, no. So then it is not reflexive, not transitive. If we add another one, so here we can find it. Okay, sorry. If it is a transit, we are adding 2, 3 here. Then for making it symmetric, we have to add 3, 2. Right? If we are adding 2, 3 there, then for making it symmetric, we have to add 3, 2. Now this is the relation which is equivalence as the all the elements are there. So therefore, we can see there is only one relation in A is equals to 1, 2, 3, which is a reflexive and symmetric but not transitive. Okay, there is only one, and this one is a not. Okay, because it is become transitive. So therefore, your answer is one. There is only one relation we can define, and that is your answer is option A. Now let me see question number 17 of the same chapter, same exercise, is miscellaneous. Here A is equals to 1, 2, 3. Then number of equivalence relation containing 1, 2. So here question number 17, A is equals to 1, 2, 3. Now number of the equivalence relation containing 1, 2. So here if I write down R is equals to 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, then 2, 2, then 3. It has become reflexive. Now it contains 1, 2. So 1, 2 is there. Then for the making it symmetric, we have to add 2, 1. Remember students, हमें equivalence relation चाहिए. तो equivalence relation के लिए आपको क्या करना पड़ेगा? Reflexive and symmetric and transitive, तीनों property का satisfaction चाहिए आपको. So for this reflexivity के लिए हमने 1, 1, 2, 2 and 3, 3 add कर दिए. Now 1, 2 is there. Equation is containing 1, 2. So 1, 2 add किया तो वहाँ पे 2, 1 भी हमें add करना पड़ेगा. Now let me see the transitive. How many transitive are there? So if 1, 2 is there, 1, 2 and 2, 1, then 1, 1 is there. Yes. 2, 2 and 2, 1, then 2, 2 and 2, 1, then 2, 1 is there. Yes. So this relation, firstly this relation is equivalence because it is a reflexive, it is symmetric, and there are all the elements A, B and B, C are there, and A, C belongs to R. So therefore it is transitive. So one relation is this, which is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. Now I am adding another element 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. Now 1, 2 and 2, 1 is there. We are adding one more, that is 1, 3. Now you know that the question is how many equivalence relation. So equivalence के लिए हमें क्या करना पड़ेगा? If 1, 3 we have add, तो symmetric बनाने के लिए हमें वहाँ पे 3, 1 add करना. Now for making it transitive, we have to add 2, 3 and 3, 2. Then only this will become the transitive. So therefore we are adding a two relation, R1 and R2, which is an equivalence relation. So therefore your answer will be option B, that is 2. Now with this, these are the question based on types of the relation. Now let me see now some question based on the second type, that is types of function. So here the questions are, now types of function, in this the question we are having from the exercise 1.2. Let me see, two MCQs are there, 11 and 12. Question number 11 is here, two questions are there, exercise 1.2, question number 11. So question is, let f is a function from R to R defined by f of x is equals to x raised to 4. Then choose the correct answer. F is 1, 1 and 1, 2. F is many 1, 1, 2. F is 1, 1 but not 1, 2. F is neither 1, 1 nor 1. So here your first question is f of x is equals to x raised to 4, and our function is from R to R. So here it is not 1, 1 and not 1. I can say directly. Why? Because here R is a function from, f is a function from R to R, and is x raised to 4. So if I find out two elements directly, for x1 is equals to 1, x1 is equals to minus 1. You can find out f of x1, 1 raised to 4, that is 1. F of x2, minus 1 raised to 4, that is 1. And the infinitely many elements we have in this type of condition can be satisfied. So f is not 1. Now, second, it is not onto. Why it is not onto? Because power. X raised to 4. Now, x is positive or negative, but power is even number. So, it will be a positive. So, therefore, here, range of f will be r plus, which is not equals to r. All the negative elements are excluded. So, therefore, we can say f is not 1, 1, not onto. So, your answer is option D. Now, next question is question number 12 from the same exercise. So, there is a question f from r to r and f of x is equals to 3x. Now, students, f of x is equals to 3x. Now, this question I am leaving to you. You can check this 1, 1 and onto or not. Okay? So, for this, you can check very easily. Now, one more question we can see. That is from the miscellaneous exercise, question number 10. In the miscellaneous question number 10. So, you can see that, find the number of all the onto functions from the set 1, 2, 3 up to n to itself. So, remember students here, the number of, here you can remember, as there is given. Number of onto function from x to x, where x is finite set with n elements, then number of onto function from x to x where n element is n factorial. So here, if they have changed your set as x is equals to whatever, then you can write down the answer as a n factorial. If x is equals to 1, 2, 3, then total number of the onto function from 1, 2, 3 to 1, 2, 3 will be 3 factorial, that is 6. So, this is the answer of the question number 10. 11 is, if S is equals to ABC and D is equals to 1, 2, 3, these are two sets, then find out the F inverse from F to function from S to T if exist. So, this question, we have seen this type of question earlier too. So, that you can solve by yourself. So, question number 12, I am giving up to you for solving. So, now, let me see the next method of this chapter. That is, now, the next is our topic is composition and the invertible function. Now, students, in the composition, we know that how to define, we have seen so many equations here, f composition of g composition of f, then invertible function, if f composition of g is identity, here f composition of g composition of f is identity on x, here the identity on y, then we can say f and g are, f is the invertible function and g is the inverse of the function g. Now, let me see a few questions based on it. So, it is the question from exercise 1.3. Question number 13. Exercise 1.3. Question number 13. Here, if f of x is equals to 3 minus x cube, 4 raised to 1 by 3, then what can be the f composition of f of x? So, this is we have to find out. Now, for this question, what we have to do? First, f of x. F of x is 3 minus x cube raised to 1 by 3. x by the second hand. So this is 3 minus x cubed whole raised to 1 by 3. And what is your exponents? Here it is 3 minus x cubed whole raised to 1 by 3. Okay. So this is the theory. Now here 3 and 3 will be plotted. So it is 3 minus 3 plus x cubed whole raised to 1 by 3. 3 and 3 is third, now x cube raised to 1 upon 3. So it will be again x cube raised to 1 upon 3, that is equal to x. So here your answer is option C. Now next question is question number 14. Here f is a function from r minus 4 by 3 to r, where f of x is defined as 4x upon 3x plus 4. Then the inverse of f is the map g from the range of f to so on. So here you have to find out the inverse of this function. For this we have to take f of x is equals to 1. We know the method how to find out the inverse. So now f of x is equals to 4x upon 3x plus 4 is equals to 1. Now converts to this function in the terms of x, you will get x is equals to 4y upon 4 minus 3y upon 4 minus 3. So this will be your answer. So with this, the question based on composition and the invertible function is over. Now one more question from the miscellaneous, that is question number 18. So let me see that question. Let f from r to r be a signum function defined as f of x is equals to 1 if x is greater than 0, 0 if x is equals to 0, and minus 1 if x is less than 0. And g coincide and 0 to 1. So for this, let me find out if x belongs to open 0 to close to 1. So if x belongs to this, then what can be f of x? Look students, here if x is greater than 0, then fx will give you the value 1. If x is equals to 0 but 0 is not there and x is less than, then minus 1. So this is only applicable for the first one. So f of x is equals to 1. And what can be the g of x? So g of x means the greatest integer which is belong to 0 to 1. Now if we take from 0 to 1, then it will be the integer which is smaller than it. Okay, then smaller than means it will be 0. And therefore here it will depend if x is belongs to 0 to 1. And 1 if x belongs to if x is equals to 1. Okay, so in this case you can see in 0 to 1 fx and gx are not having the same value. Okay, therefore we can say no, f and g are not coincide in the interval 0 to 1. So with this students, this is our chapter number 1 is going to be over. Now in the next video we will see the next chapter of this. Okay, so till then, please study well, please read for the whole chapter again. Thank you and have a nice day.